But the seer prophets see before they fly. They already know where to go and what's going on. And I was standing over there about 20 minutes or so ago, and the Lord was outside those windows, and he said, "My train is about to fill this temple." Before they started saying it. He said, "My train is going to fill this temple. It's going to be rocked." And I'm telling you, angels by the hundreds and thousands began to jump in, spin in, slide in. There was so much water, I just wanted to yell, "It's raining." I wanted to yell, "It's raining, grab the rain, grab the rain," because they were just sliding in the water. What's coming from everywhere, it was from heaven, it was water coming from heaven, and they were jumping on here, not just here, they were actually doing that in heaven, because they were celebrating what was going on here. So what happened was, we literally connected with heaven in the worship. This is a fun time, and at the same time, this is a holy time. And a lot of people, I know when I started speaking, some of the body had a problem seeing themselves as being fun or funny and that being holy. But it's part of being holy. I mean, why wouldn't you have fun if you were free from any effects of the enemy or the world or man whatsoever? You will have more fun than you've ever had in your life. The glory is the power of God. And we on this earth are supposed to belong to him. We're supposed to be demonstrating that power, releasing that power. And we have come short of it. A lot of people come short of it because they're playing in the world. They're playing in the enemy's camp. And they can't even see what they're missing. They can't see who they're supposed to be. Father, I speak now to the body of Christ. Those who are running. Those who are hiding. Those who are sitting. Those who are blind. Those who are confused, those who are trapped by the enemy, I call you forth from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. It's time for you to get in here. Stand up for him. Let go of your shackles. Let go of your blinders. Don't be blind. Don't be confused. Don't be trapped, because he will not tolerate nor put up with pharmacia ruling over people. Abortion ruling over people. Necromancy ruling over people. Evil ruling over his people. He will cut down every weed, and it will be burned up by the fire of his presence. He will not tolerate it in this state, in this country. He is going to deal with it. He's going to deal all that is not right. He's going to set it right. And those who call themselves his leaders, that are lying, that are cheating, are living sin and pouring into the congregation. You have days, you have weeks left to make it right with him, or he will remove you from this earth. He will not tolerate you saying you represent him and you walk in ungodliness and you say he is your God. He will not know you if you do not change your ways. You will not live to see the day of his glory on this earth. So repent and come back to him if you want to live and not die. You were appointed by God to carry the glory, but will that glory expose you, or will you carry it? Because he will not tolerate you using his name and making his name something that is bad and evil. Yes, he sees your sin, and just because he doesn't say anything doesn't mean he's not going to do anything, because he's saying in this day and hour, you better change your ways and change your life if you want to remain on this earth. Because he won't let you carry the glory. He won't let you manifest. He won't let you demonstrate. He will replace you and take your place from you.